Hello, my name is Dr. Danielle Carnival. My pronouns are she, her, and I currently serve as White House Cancer Moonshot Coordinator in the White House Office of Science and Technology Policy. I lead the effort to realize the President's vision to end cancer as we know it. The goal of the Cancer Moonshot is to reduce cancer death rate by 50% by 2040 and to better support patients through their cancer journey. I'm with the Veterans Affairs Under Secretary for Health to talk about how the VA is at the forefront of the 2022 Cancer Moonshot as a key member of the President's Cancer Cabinet.
Hello, Danielle. I'm Dr. Shereef Elnahal. My pronouns are he and him. And I'm excited to share with you how VA is ready, willing, and has already begun taking on the President's challenge. I'm so glad the Cancer Moonshot is part of the national healthcare conversation again. To provide context about VA's cancer care for veterans, VA cares for about 450,000 veterans with cancer every year, making VA one of the largest integrated oncology care providers in the United States. About 43,000 veterans are diagnosed with cancer each year, and millions are considered at risk.
Before we get into all the great work VA is doing under the Cancer Moonshot, can you talk a bit about how VA's cancer support to veterans will expand with the recent passage of the PACT Act?
The PACT Act is perhaps the largest healthcare and benefit expansion in VA's history. It expands VA healthcare and benefits for veterans exposed to burn pits and other toxic substances during their service. The PACT Act will ensure generations of veterans and their survivors can receive the benefits and care they've earned and deserve. PACT expands the presumptive conditions list to include 12 different types of cancer, including respiratory cancers, lymphoma of any kind, and cancers affecting reproductive organs.
And how does the Cancer Moonshot come into play with the PACT Act?
VA's Cancer Moonshot effort has three programs that are supporting the investigation into service-related environmental exposures. The programs are molecular analysis, researching carcinogenic exposures, applied proteogenomics, organizational learning and outcomes, or APOLLO, and the two-way cancer registry. These programs do not directly impact toxic exposures. However, they are designed to develop critical data elements that will provide structured results for the long term.
Can you share one or two examples of the Moonshot programs that will support the PACT Act?
Well, VA's Moonshot efforts range from expanding programs initiated in Cancer Moonshot 1.0, like VA's National Precision Oncology Program, to programs and partnerships that are new in VA. In response to then-Vice President Biden's Cancer Moonshot call for action in 2016, VA has been working with the Defense Department and the National Cancer Institute on a discovery to learning healthcare consortium called APOLLO. APOLLO incorporates emerging precision medicine methods into patient care across military treatment facilities and VA hospitals. These new methods build upon existing genomic sequencing methods already used to look beyond the genome. That is, the activity and expression of the proteins that the genome encodes, so we can have a functional understanding of individual differences in the development of cancer. Then we can tailor treatments based on these new insights. As we gain more insights on molecular differences at the individual level, it is critical that we bring in clinical data and biospecimens of active duty members and veterans treated in the APOLLO network before they are diagnosed with cancer. This is important because military service often disproportionately exposes members to toxic exposures. In response to President Biden's 2022 charge to reignite the Cancer Moonshot effort, the APOLLO program has already expanded its already extensive network by adding the Environmental Protection Agency and the NIH's National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences to create a foundational, integrated, longitudinal, early discovery to clinical healthcare implementation framework for monitoring and studying the short and long-term effects of toxic exposures, including respiratory illnesses, autoimmune disorders, and cancer. The effort is called Prometheus, or the Project for Military Exposures and Toxin History Evaluation in U.S. Service Members. Approximately 25% of all cancer diagnoses in VA are rare cancers. Because of Cancer Moonshot, we are developing a program specifically focused on addressing these rare cancers. We have roadmapped subspecialty clinical teams to support veterans' complex cancer diagnoses. And if a veteran is diagnosed with a rare cancer or a common cancer with a complex presentation, we can support them. The Moonshot will expand access to standardized molecular testing that is clinically usable and can be leveraged for making decisions about targeted therapies for rare cancers.
I'm curious about how the Moonshot will expand or build up some of the existing cancer programs VA already has.
Well, VA's Moonshot Initiative has a total of 12 work streams focused on the continuum of cancer care, including prevention, screening, diagnosis, treatment, and research. VA is working to diligently bring cancer screening and cancer care to veterans in their communities. For example, through decentralized clinical trials. VA has many veterans who need lung cancer screening, and the Moonshot will support the expansion of our award-winning National Lung Cancer Screening Program. The Moonshot is also supporting a greater emphasis on health equity through targeted outreach to historically underserved communities. Examples of this are the Moonshot Mailed FIT program, where we are piloting and sending out colorectal cancer screening tests to veterans in their homes so we can meet veterans where they are. The use of teleoncology to provide care to veterans in geographically remote areas and expanding the number of sites engaged in clinical trials.
How are veterans part of the cancer research conversation? Cancer research is a critical element of the Cancer Moonshot across the public and federal responses to the president's call to action.
Well, through the National Clinical Research Network developed in the VA, veterans can have access to clinical trials and can participate in research. This effort is enhanced by our ability to conduct decentralized clinical trials and reach veterans where they live. Researchers use veteran engagement groups to help understand prior experiences, barriers in access to care, and participation in research studies. They also provide valuable input that helps to inform study designs and ensure that veterans can enroll in studies. VA has a robust national infrastructure that supports conducting cancer research. In fact, the first multi-site clinical trials in the United States began in the VA healthcare system. And clinical trials have served as the gold standard for producing evidence for treatments and care for veterans and others. When a veteran is diagnosed with cancer, participating in a relevant clinical trial could be part of their standard care. Veterans don't have to fail a treatment to qualify for participation in a clinical trial. And VA researchers apply big data tools to identify better treatments, guide care decisions, and build opportunities for research to improve oncology care.
It sounds like VA can significantly contribute to cancer research based on the infrastructure and the integrated nature of the system. I'm curious what VA is doing under the Cancer Moonshot specifically to further cancer research.
Something we are very excited to stand up under the Moonshot is the ENACT program. ENACT aims to promote a culture of clinical trials and standard cancer clinical care, provide veterans and others with rare and deadly cancer greater access to cutting-edge therapies, accelerate scientific discovery, and promote VHA as a leader in cancer care and research. ENACT is also working to increase equity in accessing clinical trials by understanding and reducing barriers that different groups face in participating in the right clinical trials. An ongoing VA clinical trial will help researchers determine the most effective screening test for colorectal cancer by comparing home-based screening to colonoscopy in 50,000 veterans, the largest interventional study in VA history. VA has partnerships with federal agencies, including the NCI, DOE, DOD, and the Department of Energy, like the NCI-designated cancer centers through our academic affiliations, and the pharmaceutical industry, and various philanthropic organizations who are interested in working with VA to do clinical trials and bring novel therapeutic options to veterans. For example, VA has an existing partnership with the National Cancer Institute to improve access to clinical trials taking place at NCI-affiliated centers. Also, VA has a partnership with the Prostate Cancer Foundation to support precision oncology trials for veterans with prostate cancer. In fact, we have an entire office dedicated to making sure we understand the impact of environmental exposures on the lives of veterans. As part of VA's Office of Patient Care Services, the Health Outcomes Military Exposures Office administers programs related to environmental and occupational exposures of veterans, including studying cancer rates among conflict and occupational cohorts.
The Cancer Moonshot seems to give the VA the opportunity to strengthen its cancer care capabilities. Is there anything in particular about the Moonshot that excites you as a physician?
The talent and expertise in cancer research in VA is deep, and we are bringing it to bear. Everyone is eventually impacted by cancer, whether it be a loved one or your own diagnosis. And VA can truly bring about the Moonshot goal of reducing cancer deaths. Moonshot is a uniting force behind research, clinical care, patient stories, and caregivers. We're all in this together, and we can't reach that goal without everyone's input. It is important to have a national focus on cancer care and reduce cancer mortality.
Thank you for sharing these thoughts with me, and I'm excited to see us work together to bring about the goals of the Moonshot. Where can veterans and other folks learn more about VA and oncology care?
Well, they can visit cancer.va.gov for more information or contact our VA team at cancer@va.gov. And any veteran or survivor can learn more about the PACT Act by visiting va.gov/PACT or calling 1-800-MY-VA-411. Thank you so much for this discussion, Danielle.
Thank you for VA's leadership on this issue and to all of you for tuning in and learning more.